వందేహం శ్రీగురు శ్రీయుత పదకమలం.
Yes.
Prabhupada, it is written in Bhagavad Gita that we just read from, about having faith and that Krishna will provide for us. And also, further on in the Gita, it is said that God helps those who help themselves.
Yes.
Now, how should we determine we should determine our...
He helps themselves, you put yourself under Krishna. That is helping yourself. And if you think, oh, I can protect myself, then you are not helping yourself. Just like this finger, so long it is healthy, working, if there is some trouble, I can spend thousands of dollars for this. But if this finger is cut off from my body, if you trample down with your feet this finger, I don't care for it. Similarly, to help oneself means to put oneself in the proper position as part and parcel of Krishna. That is real helping. Otherwise, how you can help? The finger can help itself by putting itself in the proper position of the hand and work for the whole body. That is proper position. If the fingers thinks that I shall remain separated from this body and help myself, it will die. So as soon as we think that I shall live independently without caring for Krishna, that is my death. And as soon as I engage myself as part and parcel of Krishna, that is my life. So helping oneself means to know one's position and work in that way. That is helping. Without knowing what is his position, how one can help oneself? It is not possible. Yes?
Then we should always try to act discriminately and always try to serve Krishna, not have Krishna serve us.
Huh?
Always feel that we should try to serve Krishna.
Yeah.
Not say that we will do this and Krishna will provide, or Krishna will help us.
No, you are serving Krishna, that is, means you are doing. Serving means doing. What do you mean by serving? Actually, when you serve somebody, are you not doing something? You are engaged in serving Krishna. How? You are going to preach Krishna consciousness, you are cooking, you are cleansing, you are somebody doing something. So helping Krishna means doing. Helping Krishna does not mean you sit down tiredly. That is Krishna consciousness activities. Whatever asset you have got to work, utilize it for Krishna. That is bhakti. Now we have got what assets we have got? We have got the mind. All right, think of Krishna. We have got this hand, wash the temple, or cook for Krishna. We have got these legs, go to the temple of Krishna. We have got this nose, smell the flowers offered to Krishna. So you can engage. So Krishna consciousness engage means working, activity. Arjuna, He was declined to act. Krishna was infusing it. To act. This is the whole Bhagavad Gita. Krishna consciousness does not mean that no work. To engage yourself in Krishna consciousness means to work for Krishna. Krishna does not say, of course in this chapter Krishna will say something about, he never said Arjuna, oh, my dear friend Arjuna, you don't care for this world, you sit down and meditate upon me. Have you seen in this Bhagavad Gita? This meditation means to stop all nonsense work. Sit down tightly. But those who are advanced in Krishna consciousness, they have to work for Krishna. Just like child, simply disturbing the home mother says, my dear child, sit down here. But if you can work nicely, he asks mother, asks my dear boy, you have to do this, you have to do that, you have to do that. To sit down tightly for the nonsense, not for the sensible. For the nonsense, the more he sits down, at least he does not commit any nonsense. That's all. Negation of nonsense, that is not positive. Here is positive activities. So negation is no life. Positive life is life. Don't do this is no life. Do this, this is life. But, you know, to do rightly, there are something don't. Don't is not life. Do is life. All Bhagavad Gita is do. Do fight for me. There is nothing don't. Arjuna wanted, don't induce me. And Krishna did not like that. You are speaking like non-Aryan. Kutasti kasmalamidam anarja jushtam. It is this kind of words are spoken by the non-Aryans. He was accused of being non-Aryan. Anarja. So Krishna consciousness does not mean sitting idly. No. We have the whole pastimes of Krishna's fuller activities. When you go to the spiritual world, Krishna is always dancing, you have to 24 hours dance there. And eat there. Where is sit down? There is no question of sit down. Have you heard anything about gopis meditating? Sit down. Have you heard? That Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he said, what is that? Dancing. Hare Krishna. You see, spirit, you are spirit soul, how you can stop yourself silent? That is not possible. Arjuna refused. When you will find in this chapter, when Arjuna was recommended, my dear Arjuna, you meditate. He immediately refused, my dear Krishna, it is not possible for me. It is not possible for me. That is the actual fact. How it is possible for him? He was a householder man. He wanted kingdom. He wanted to rule over the country. where is the time for his meditation? He flatly refused, "My dear Krishna, it is not possible for me." He says that controlling the mind, vāyurīva śudhuṣkaraṁ, it is as difficult as to control the air. That is a fact. You have to engage the mind in Krishna, then it is controlled. Otherwise, artificial, you cannot control. It is impossible. Arjuna said, what to speak of others? Arjuna, who is Arjuna? Personally talking with Krishna. Do you think he is an ordinary man? He said that it is impossible. Vāyurēva śudhuṣkaraṁ, this very example he has given. Chanchala himmana Krishna pramāthi balavadriram. My dear Krishna, you are asking me to control the mind. It is so powerful that and restless. I think to control the mind is as good as to control the air. If there is high wind, can you control it? He gives this example. You can control the mind when you fix up the mind in Krishna's lotus feet. That's all. No nonsense can come within your mind. Simply Krishna. That is perfection of meditation.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.